It's a good product. The quality is on point, especially for the price that you pay. These things are insanely expensive if you buy them from other vendors or manufacturers. The use case, I need to warn you about it. It is not as great as it seems.
Initiating.
Welcome back. Welcome back to my daily grind. Create yourself is what you'll find me doing every day and every night. No time to lose, one day, one step in the right direction. I'm Chris and I'm only here to show you if I can do it, you can do it too.
Welcome back to the vlog. It is Saturday and our day A in our chance to push hard, and the topic for this vlog is the review of this Chinese color checker, so let's get it. By the way, all the product reviews right here, watch them all, but before we get started, love goes out to all my subscribers. Thank you for making another special and worth living to the max, so let me try to give back with a sweet, sweet video. Before we get started, this was such an unnecessary purpose, and if you want to know why, it is so backwards thinking and stupid to get a color checker, then check out this video. This thing all in all is stupid. It's not working as expected. You will need a way higher quality card, which is way different than this. I thought this will make everything so easy with DaVinci Resolve. You apply the grid and then it will do it automatically. Oh my goodness, far from it. It's completely useless. But that's not the topic for this vlog. Let's actually talk about the thing itself. Now, first of all, these values back here, they are Chinese, and these check out to be, well, this I took the time and I scanned all the letters, the Chinese letters, with Google Lens and then translated them. Aside from that, the product itself, I mean, that's a bit rough, but other than that, like, the product itself is pretty solid. I can't complain about the product. It's a good card, and I think that the colors itself, they are decent. Now, this is a copy of the Color Checker Classic, I think, if I have this in mind correctly. I was into this a month ago, like, completely crazy. But yeah, I mean, it's a good product. The quality is on point, especially for the price that you pay. These things are insanely expensive if you buy them from other vendors or manufacturers. But the use case, I need to warn you about it. It is not as great as it seems. It's not. You can use these shades of gray to dial in your white balance and stuff, but this is so over the top. This is, oh my goodness. Like, you're, oh my god, this is so crazy. You need to start somewhere way else. Like, way else. And this is so over the top. Even for me, I do custom white balance, I do custom aperture, blink speed, shutter speed, and ISO. Like, I do everything custom. I shoot with my own custom profile, Sony a7 III. You can check out best color profile right here. I do all of that custom. I shoot flat image and then I do the color correction in post. But this takes it to a whole other level, which is totally over the top and useless. So all in all, the product is good, but I cannot recommend that you get it. It's so stupid. Watch the other video that I mentioned. I made cringingly bad experiences with this thing. So unnecessary. Ugh, why did I get this? Anyways, I guess I will see you in the other video, because that's it for this one. Smash the like button away. I might even smash this freaking color checker because it's so useless to me. Bang the bell like crap to never miss product reviews, and check the recent news on chrisviral.com. And yeah, that's it for today. I will see you tomorrow.